Hey guys, Jason the X for SCNS Live, and doing a tour review, and let me start off, hey, it's troubling times out there. I'm trying to do things that are familiar to me and make me feel comfortable, so I'm doing some tour reviews. And I got a good one this week. I got the Marvel Legends Crimson Dynamo Build-A-Figure Wave, or the Black Widow Wave, and yeah, it's pretty good. It fills some holes in the collection and gives us some new movie figures, so let's go ahead and kick it off with my least favorite to my favorite, and finishing off with a Build-A-Figure, which I don't count, you know. But anyway, let's move on. Okay, my least favorite figure in this line, and it should be no surprise. It's Marvel's Spy Master. I could care less. Who gives a crap about Spy Master? Look at this lame yellow. Okay, I'm sorry. Oh man. Ooh, the venom is spewing. It's spewing, I'm telling you. It's a crap figure. Anyway, so looking at the box, you got the Marvel at the top, build a figure. Got the Marvel Spy Master. Look at this dork. Oh man. Anyway, reading off his description. An undercover operative skilled in sabotage, Spy Master possesses superb fighting skills. Oh, there has to be a lame one out of the batch for me. There always is. And that honor is going to this creep. I'm telling you, just, okay. Ooh, boy, how are we gonna get through this? How are we gonna do this? Okay, let me tilt my, I've messed up my camera out of sheer rage. Just, okay, so here's Spy Master. He's got this weird dial thing on his head. Maybe that just, I don't know. The sculpting is pretty good on this mask. I'll give him that. I like the nose. I'm going to say something nice about this figure. He's got the paint's very clean going around here. He's got a peg hole in the back. I will say there's not a lot of, I mean, he's got some little flexi yellow there. He looks like a bad psycho. He's got a stupid S on his belt. Oh man, I can't dog this figure enough. I don't even know what to make of his emblem here. Come on, camera, work with me here. Work with me. His logo here. It's a knife on a grid circle background, and he's got the stupid S on his chest. Yellow belt, got some little design, there's some little whatever, I don't know, grenades maybe, pouches on the side, got a holster with some little detail for the yellow, glue on the legs, and yellow all the way down, just, ooh, man. Spy Master, this guy kind of sucks. But hey, he's going right in the bin. So, accessory-wise, he does come with the gun that we saw with Yon Rogue in the Captain Marvel wave. And it's a nice gun. It's all in red. He holds it fairly well. There we go. Look, he's holding it. He's holding his yellow gun. And this guy was an Iron Man villain. And apparently was able to give Iron Man some sort of fight, I guess. I don't know. He's got a lame little pistol. Anyway, at the boot, or at the foot, articulation-wise, he goes back and forth. You got the peg inside the foot. Get some rotation there. Go, you know, all the way around. You know, maybe you'll twist an ankle. You got a calf rotation here, double jointed knees. Got a swivel at the thigh. Van Damme's about that far. Swivel at the waist. He's got some detented ratchet joints. Oh, look, you can see all the way up in there. That yellow plastic, the color of, you know, Budweiser exiting your body. Anyway, the arms go up about that far, twist at the bicep, double jointed elbows, and rotation at the wrist, and goes back and forth at the wrist here. Same thing on the other arm, no different articulation at the wrist. Head on a ball joint and a swivel joint. So there you go. And go all the way around. And yeah, there's Spy Master. Quick comparison. Let's bring in my standard for comparison. I'm going to go ahead and compare him to Worthy Cap right there. And let me bring my camera down a little bit so you can really just kind of see the height on this guy. So there you go. Oop, too far. There we go. There's the money spot. So yeah, he's a little bit taller than an MCU figure. But yeah, there's a Spymaster, the worst one of the line, the one I could care less about. Bam! Oh, Cap rules again. Okay, on to the next figure in the line. We have the Red Guardian figure, and I dislike this figure for a lot of reasons. Let me get into it. Okay, so that, why is he so low on this? I'm gonna tell you why. Anyway, so we got Legend Series right there. Artwork on the side of the box. Look at that. Look at that. He's got a cowl or a helmet on his head. They've really toned down the beard. But anyway, on the back, you've got Alexei Shotoskov. Is that Shotoskov? Is a super soldier and spy who's lived a lifetime of triumph during the Cold War. All right. Let's bring in Red Guardian here. What do we instantly notice that he appears to be missing? That's right, a cowl. Also, judging from the trailer, this is a really toned down version of that beard. That beard looks like it smells of vodka and potatoes. I'm sorry. Yes, condoms, tears. Anyway, and this does not look like that. Okay, this is a good David Harbour head. I'll give him that. But I don't think it's a very good Alexei head from the Black Widow movie. I just don't. Let's get a little bit closer on some detail here. So you've got, there's the head. You got a little bit of graying in the hairline there. Just a little bit. Not a lot. Come on, camera, focus. This is a good, like I said, good David Harbour head. A little bit of graying in the beard. All of this is molded detail on here. The buckles, I like that. So is the star, still fits. Got the pouches here. Pouches look good. I swear I've seen these gauntlets from somewhere before. Kind of looks like Ant-Man's gauntlets. Anyway, got the pouches going around. Got a hole in the back to store the shield, which we'll look at the accessories later. You got the straps going around halfway to the leg. And coming around to the front, I've got a little bit of a paint defect on mine. And then you got down here to the boots. Boots look good. This figure looks good and could have been there. I think they really should have included a head with the cowl so we could really get the Red Guardian. And this just doesn't seem... This figure, it seems like they got lazy. I'm going to admit, it looks like they got lazy. Or they did the design so far ahead that they didn't have time. I don't know, but... This figure has some shortcomings, and that's all I can say. For the accessory he does come with, he comes with a shield. And this shield's pretty nice. It's got some, this is all molded detail with the star and also the buckles here. This could have easily been a painted piece. So this is where I'm like, hey, good job with the figure. Does he have this shield anywhere in the movie is what I'm asking, though, because all I've seen, he doesn't appear to be carrying. I know Red Guardian in the comics does. And apologies on the comparison. I could not find my Red Guardian figure from that Ant-Man wave or Giant Man wave, but yeah. And of course, you can just clip the shield onto his arm here. Did I clip it onto here? There we go. Okay, clip it onto the wrist, and it holds on there. And of course, with the peg, you can put onto his back. It's a substantial size shield, but yeah, they really should have included a cowled head to really get this figure. Anyway, articulation, standard Marvel Legends. You got the peg in the foot, rotate around. You got the swivel there. Got a cut at the calf, double jointed knees. Got the swivel at the thigh. He Van Damme's about that far. Twist at the waist. The belt is a separate piece. Got an ab crunch with like a couple of clicks in there. Head on a ball joint with a swivel. Wait, that's not a ball joint. I mean, that's not a swivel. It does have a ball joint, but he's got that recessed peg in there. Look at that. Aha. I thought everything was standard on this guy. I was wrong. Can I pop his head off? Can you? You can. Aha. So look, he's got that peg with the barbell joint in there. So no swivel, which I think is a detriment to the figure. Why? Get on there. All right, there we go. Arms will go full 360 at the shoulder, goes up about that far on that universal joint, swivel at the bicep, double jointed elbows, and a twist at the wrist, and goes back and forth, very stiff on this one. Hang on, there we go. Goes back and forth at the wrist. Comparison-wise, let's just go ahead and bring in, get up there. Let's see here. Ah! Stand, damn it. Comparison-wise, I'm looking for my figures. What have I done here? So, comparison-wise, look, here is a Captain America figure. And he's a bit taller than our Chris Evans-worthy Cap figure. But, you know, he would have looked so much better if he had just had the cowl or a better head from the movie. And that's why this figure, it ranks a little bit lower for me. They could have done better. But yeah, there he is, Red Guardian. And for the next figure of the line, I am reviewing the Crossbones figure. Now, I don't have that one that came out a while ago where he had like these big Hydra guns. I ended up selling that to a friend of mine because it wasn't that good. It was a reuse of a lot of parts. This is more that classic Crossbones design, and I like it. So let's go ahead and get him out of the way. Let's check him out. We got the Marvel Emboss logo up here, Legends. You got Marvel's Crossbones on the side, more of that great art. God, I love the mask on this guy. Looks like a... looks so luchador. Anyway, Marvel's Crossbones. Crossbones makes it his mission. Zoomed in too far. Makes his mission to take out Captain America, no matter the loss of life at stake. Ooh. Liz, put the dog in her house, please. Oh, hell, it drives me nuts. Anyway, okay, moving on. I had to shoot my kids and knock over Crossbones, shoot my kids and the dog out of the room where everybody came in. So anyway, take a look at Crossbones here. Really good character. Kind of needed in this Marvel Legends line because it just wasn't a good representation of it, in my opinion. There was that big one, but it just didn't do it. But look at this mask. Oh, man. Love the look of the mask. I'm a big fan of wrestling and luchador wrestling especially, so I love the mask. More wrestlers need to use the tied up mask. Got two peg holes in the back. This is a reuse of a body mold. But yeah, you got the crossbone at the top there. Very muscular, not overly muscular like Crossbones. Good leathering, leather work, leather effect on the holsters and the belt. He has these wrist pouches. These are dumb. The wrist pouches are dumb. We've seen this gun with, I believe, the 90s Cable. So let me get that out of his way. And let go. Let go. Anyway, move down to the figure. He does have these holsters, like I said, and he has more of that gun that came with Yon Rogue. Two of them, in fact. Kind of a stark contrast. Anyway, very, very just plain black on the plastic on the legs. Got some shinier black on the boots. Boots have a little bit of tread on the bottom of them. And got a peg hole. I like this figure. I know it's not fancy, but for a Crossbones figure, this is all we really need. And moving back to those accessories that the figure comes with, he does have this little double barrel cannon that we did see with Cable. Also pretty much a accurate representation of a certain Nerf gun. This looks just like that Nerf gun. Like the double-barreled shotgun that had like a break, you load the darts inside. I had this Nerf gun. So yeah, you get two of those. You can't holster these. You can only put them in his hands. However, the little laser pistol thing we've just seen with Spymaster. Oh, he's so stupid. So you get two of those. Like I said, you can't fit those in his hands. I guess we can do one of each in each hand. Let's do it over here. Since that one was a little bit difficult. So yeah, it'll fit just fine in his hand. Back this camera up a little bit. And you saw the previous ones, they also will go in his hands. So now he's got one of each. So there you go. Articulation wise, he does have nice ankle articulation. Peg is in the foot. We'll go around, spin at the calf, 360. Turn that back around. Double jointed knees. Got a twist at the thigh. He will Van Damme pretty far. I think that's the max it'll go. The holster's kind of getting away, but man, he Van Damme's. Got a twist at the waist. Soft ratchet in the chest. Arms will do a full 360 on a universal joint. Go up about that far, twist at the bicep, double jointed elbows, twist at the wrist, and these go up and down at the wrist. And, well, they both do. So they both have that motion that way. A nice double jointed, ball jointed head on a hinge. Look at that. He can really look up. Now, like I said, I don't have that old crossbones figure. I traded or sold it off, but I do have the previous version of crossbones that we got from the MCU. I know these are completely different, but you know, size, hey, there you go. That's how they look together. So yeah, I like the crossbones figure. So moving on to my next figure, it is Marvel's Winter Soldier, and it's yet another Winter Soldier figure. I think they've had a better go at this one. I know I have the other ones, but they're dug in somewhere and I just can't find them. So I'm gonna do a comparison to something else later. Anyway, so you got the box, the Crimson Dynamo Marvel Legends. Let me just zoom in a little bit here. Winter Soldier on the side. I love this artwork on the side from these characters. Love it. It's great. It's different. So there you go. On the back, Winter Soldier is a fierce combatant and an asset in battle, no matter which team he fights for. I think that does matter. I'm gonna go ahead and tell you right now, that absolutely does matter, especially to me. Now moving on to Bucky or the Winter Soldier. Gonna go ahead and get his accessories out of his hand because I am gonna talk a little bit about those. But getting close on the face there. Come on, Zoom. Good head sculpt. I think that's really good. Got the domino mask is very well defined. Got this weird kind of like line in the middle of mine. Might be just a defect on my side. Not sure, but it's there. Love the wrinkles in the face. He looks a little bit older than he should, but it's a good head sculpt. So on the body, you are seeing probably some reuse of some parts here. I kind of wish I had pulled them out, but you can see clearly his Bucky-ish vest underneath. Probably something reused from one of the Winter Soldier figures from the movie. On this side, you got just the regular arm. Kind of got some wrinkles and folds in the fabric. I dig that. Wearing the fingerless gloves. On the other side, you do have his Winter Soldier arm. And he does have the star for when he, like, reformed. So this would be a good Bucky. It's a good Winter Soldier. It doesn't have the red star there anymore. I like the nice accessory of the watch here, the one that we saw with Luke Cage. They should really put that on more figures, just because it's a nice little accessory. The belt, you can see, you know, a couple grenades, a couple magazines. Got a knife, none of that's removable. Neither is this pistol. I kind of wish they had just left this holster open. You got some more magazines. I mean, he has plenty of mags, by the way. He's got some pistol, some mags for his pistol, for his assault weapon on the leg. And it is a separate piece. It is kind of wiggly on there. Another grenade on the other side. And he's got the pouches on the front, too. I like this look. It's a good look. Using the bloused BDU style pants with the boots, which is, you know, that works for Winter Soldier. But good design. I really do like this figure. Looks really good. Accessory wise, he comes with two weapons. One of them is this, appears to be a more classic Colt 45. The thing about these weapons, you see some marbling in there. They are super, like, pliable plastic. I mean, look at this. This is almost gummy. I was surprised at how soft these weapons are. Under some heat, they will start to droop. And that's a little disconcerting, but, you know, we've seen these weapons before, but the plastic that they're cast in is very soft and gummy. And it gets worse when you get to his assault weapon here, which we've seen this AR-style rifle with a grenade launcher before, with a shortened barrel, and the scope and everything. But look at this, man. I could make this touch. And then just to put it back, I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing. As you can see, there's no stress on it. There's no stress that this thing, that's how soft it is. So yeah, a little off-putting with that, but it's still, I mean, you can always replace it with other weapons if you don't, but it works for them. Just a really soft gummy plastic, and it's not evident on any of the other weapons in this line. I'm just, what? On this one. So anyway, moving back over to Bucky articulation. Boots will go up and down. Got the pin in the foot. No calf articulation, double jointed knees. Back this camera up a little bit. Got the thigh swivel here, he Van Damme's. Pretty good, actually. Yeah, definitely better than Spymaster. Anyway, got a swivel at the waist. Got a ratcheted ab crunch. Both elbows will go all the way around on the universal joint, goes up about that far. Twist at the bicep, double jointed elbows. His wrists will swivel and go back and forth that way. This one will swivel, and I'm not sure where this one goes. Okay, same as the other wrist, it goes back and forth. Head is on a ball joint that will go back and forth, and you're able to go all the way 360 around. The hair doesn't get in the way. And holding weapons, let's go ahead and just get those in his hands. Fits in fairly easy. This is why I kind of wish the holster had been left open. If there's anything I do hate about Marvel Legends figures, which is why he's kind of lower, is I hate the holsters. Also, I do like the hair, by the way. It's got black and brown in it. Couldn't tell. Dig that. But I wish they had left that holster open so we would have storage for this pistol. So, yeah. There is Bucky with a comparison. Here he is next to MCU Bucky. Put those two together. Get an idea of how big they are. Bucky. Oh, knocking stuff over. Anyway, off camera. So yeah, that's about how big he is. So yeah, that's my next figure out of the line, the Winter Soldier. All right, next figure in the Marvel Legends Black Widow series line. It is the Yelena Belova figure. And I like this figure, but there's not much to it. There really isn't. I guess she's a necessary character, but there's not much to the figure. Let's go ahead and get this out of the way. We'll bring in the packaging a little bit closer. You got the Black Widow symbol, Legends series. I need to zoom in more. Oh, this new tripod I got. It's kind of a pain. Just keeps dislodging itself. Anyway, so you got Yelena Belova right there. Artwork on the side of the package. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. I like the face on this one. So turning around here. A project of the Red Room's ruthless training program, Yelena Belova is a fiery assassin. Yes, dear sister. Anyway. So taking a look at Yelena, it's not a bad figure. She is rumored to actually be taking over for the Black Widow in the MCU. Considering that, you know, well, no spoilers. Black Widow died. Anyway, so not bad. I recognize this green vest, though. We've seen this vest. I wonder who we've seen it. I'll say that for the comparison. But yeah, the figure is kind of basic. Looking at the green, like I said, you got the green vest, got the white suit underneath. Belts, you got a little, what looks like a widow symbol right there on her belt. She has some little throwing knives right there in the side pouch. Sadly, she only comes with one holster, but yet she comes with two guns. She also has some widow stingers there. Fingerless gloves, not too bad. This all white suit, wow, that is just like, you know, I had to change the exposure for this one. But yeah, it's not a bad figure. Little arm guards there. Now, accessories, like I said, she does come with two of these pistols. I don't recall seeing these in Marvel Legends. They're, you know, small little pistols. I'm sure they do the job. Nice molding on them. And you get two pair. Now, like I said, you got one that'll fit in the holster. Nice tactical holster there. There you go. And we'll see that holster with more figures, I'm sure. Oh, and also the Yelena, she comes with two fists. I never liked the fists. I always like the hands to be able to hold something. I guess if you really need her to have a fist. But yeah, she does come with two of the fingerless gloves. But yeah, you know, options. Or she can just hold this. So she does have two molded trigger hands. So she can hold both guns. So there you go. Articulation wise, at the foot, got the peg in the foot. Can rotate all the way around. Ankle tilt back and forth. Double jointed knees. I'm sorry, does she have a... I thought she had a calf swivel, but no. She does have a thigh swivel right there. She's got these holsters attached, so she Van Damme's pretty good for that, though. Yeah, Van Damme's about that far. No waist swivel, but we do get a ball-jointed torso. Arms will go all the way around, 360. Goes up that far on that joint. Single jointed elbows, but they go pretty far. The tilt is up and down at the wrist, both sides. The head is on that peg ball joint, not the swivel one. As you can see, I'm having problems popping her head off. Wow, that is a big ball joint there. But yeah, she's got the peg inside the neck. I know they do that. God, her neck is long. I know they do that for the female figures because they want it to be just a little bit more consistent, but so there you go. Now the head's kind of loose. Hope that fixes itself. Comparison wise, I'm just going to go ahead and put her back here. We'll go ahead and bring in my unmodified Scarlet Witch, because I had to like pull everything back out and put it on her. Like I said, you got that green vest there, which is removable on this figure, not so much on this one. So yeah, that's how they look together. And I like this figure. It's a good solid figure. Not a lot of accessories, not a lot of flair with it. It's just a basic figure. Here's two guns. Boom, that character's out of the way. So yeah, Yelena Belova, not too bad. And you know, my third liked figure in the wave. All right, my second most liked figure of the wave has got to be the Spy Master. Well, that pretty much lets you know who my number one is. This is a great design on Spy Master, by the way. But my figure has some issues, and I got to compare it. I'm glad I got a buddy who collects the same stuff I do, so I can actually compare what his are like in comparison with mine. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get our newest MCU villain out of the way. Take a look at the packaging he comes in. You got the embossed Black Widow symbol up there. Legend Series. Taskmaster. Great artwork on the side. And I love this. Looks like definitely his helmet is going to play a part in his abilities. With all this data and a targeting scope and everything on there. Like I said, very good MCU interpretation of this classic Spymaster costume. Well, the character. So bring it in. Taskmaster is armed with the ability to mimic an enemy's every move. Ooh, and of course you got that artwork on the side. Nice artwork. So bringing in old Tasky in to look at his articulation and everything. Gotta say, good fig. Really good. I love this design. All three renditions of Taskmaster that they brought out in Marvel Legends. But I'm only going to keep comparing to one today because the other one, it's put away. So yeah, getting close up on that head sculpt there. Look at that. I know it's a little dark with the way the lighting is and everything. But yeah, very reflective. You got the skull teeth right in there. Also, Nate, who I do alternate heads with, he noted that looks like a camera. So he's recording all the footage from his fights and everything. So yeah, nice job with the helmet. Love the design on the hood. I kind of wish we had gotten one with the hood down, but you know, got these shoulder. It's interesting because this looks like a scarf, but it's pegged in up here. So maybe make a full scarf. Got the armor around the shoulders. Love this armor. And plus, the way that, you know, the armor kind of like fits into place when he's in just kind of a vanilla position. Got some nice T designs on these gauntlets here. Of course, I got him with his holding stuff hands. On the back, he's got like what appears to be a backpack. I'm pretty sure those will come into play at some point in the movie. But yeah, it's got like a little edge here. I'm not sure what this is. It's there. I don't know. You got some pouches on the sides here. Not too bad. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit here so I can stay in the light. Working with this new photo booth, it's rough. Here we go. So yeah, more detail on the belt, the pouches. Love the designs on like his, I guess this is more BDU style pants. You got some armor on the front. Armor on the kneecaps, always forming the T. Branding, ladies and gentlemen, branding. And you got the cut at the boot there. Nice kind of tech looking kind of boots. So yeah, that's a good fig. If not mine, has a couple problems. That's probably why he didn't end up number one. And granted, it could be just one of those things where it's mine and mine alone, but we'll see. So accessory wise, he does come with some fists, closed fists for bipping and bopping things. There you go. The other cool thing he comes with, you saw a little bit in the trailer, he comes with two claw hands. Because he's mimicking everybody, so he has some claws like Black Panther. And with those claws, he can totally rock the Wakanda forever. And this gets into kind of the posability of this guy, which I will get into. Like I said, it could be a problem. But yeah, the claws look pretty good. And as far as the other hands, he does have a trigger holding right hand, even though he doesn't have a gun. And he has just a regular open hand, no trigger hand required or needed or included. Where are my words? Other accessories he comes with, he does come with a shield, which is more of a buckler. It's a fairly small shield. Looking at it, like to put it on his arm, because I think he has it on that arm, on the, or through the box. Yeah, he usually has it on this arm. But yeah, it's kind of small, kind of puny, but it looks that way in the movie. He also has this sword, which is pretty cool looking. Looks like it's going to extend and like come from like a small, it's going to be very compact at some point. It'll grow, and you can put that in the hand that doesn't have a trigger. Let me zoom out a little bit here. It looks pretty nice. The other two accessories that he comes with, I'm going to get this off of him, are a bow and arrow. And these are pretty cool. The arrow will fit inside of the of a notch here in the bow. So you can put that in there. The problem is getting him to hold this this setup. So it's you can just put it in his hand, and then, you know, you can, I guess this arrow will probably be better served over in this hand, maybe. I've been trying to get him in some poses with it. Also like how the arrow's kind of got like a corkscrew. Anyway, but it does look cool. His, you know, got his colors and everything. Branding. But get into the articulation on this guy, and here's where, ooh boy, I'm gonna leave that there. So at the boots, you got the peg in the foot. We'll go around 360, up and down at the ankle, double jointed knees, no calf articulation. He does have a thigh cut. Van Damme's pretty well, pretty good. Not all the way, but you know, maybe one day. Wait, this actually seems to get a little further than the other one. But anyway, you've got a waist rotation. Crunch at the ball joint. No soft detents in the joint though. Arm goes out about that far. The armor will move up. And of course, all the way around 360. Wait a minute. Kind of got that little dent here that'll prevent it. Cut at the bicep. Now here's the problem. his elbow joint at the bottom. So it's double jointed. Like, this one is very stiff. But maybe he's double jointed in the film, and they were trying to show that off. But it will, they didn't do anything here, so it just goes all the way past. Maybe, like I said, maybe he's double jointed in the movie. It wouldn't surprise me. But they both do that same thing, so, I'm sorry. So double jointed elbows, the wrist will swivel all the way around, and he's got the peg that moves back and forth in this hand and this hand. So let's go ahead and get him some weapons in his hands. Comparison wise, here he is next to the other Taskmaster that was released in the Marvel Legends line. And like I said, it's a pretty good update for the MCU universe for this character. I like how he looks, and yeah, it's a pretty, I think they've nailed it pretty well. So yeah, my number two figure in the line, the Taskmaster. Now, the one thing I forgot to show in this figure that I actually, that was my biggest gripe, are the butterfly joints, which I'll just go ahead and put this in here. Mine don't seem to work correctly. If you look at the joint itself, this one will go. This one, I don't know if it's just really frozen or something, but I try and I try and I feel like I'm stressing the peg in here. So I can't get this to go. Now, I wonder if it's got something to do with this hard shell backpack, because this is not a soft plastic upper. This is a very hard one. And I can't get it to go back. I can't get it to go forward on this arm. And that kind of limits the posing that you can do with the bow. See, right now I'm trying to free it up, but man, it's just, I might work with it some more. Oh, look, the joint will actually go, the armor will actually go underneath there. But yeah, I feel like I'm really stressing that joint. So I've kind of stopped working with it. I might try to like wedge something in there and see if I can maybe push from here with something padded. But yeah, my shoulder joints are a little frozen up on this guy. And that's my main gripe with him. And the last figure of the line, and the one that I think is the best, just because she doesn't get enough love, it is the Black Widow figure. And this is a really good one. I love this Black Widow. I like, and this is probably my favorite costume that I've seen her in. So anyway, moving ahead, we got the Emboss logo up there, Legends. You got Black Widow there. There's some artwork on the side, not too bad. Very red hair, very red hair. And you got some different artwork on the back. Natasha Romanoff reunites with a group of spies from her past to stop a lethal force. So throw that to the side. And here we are with our final figure of the line. It is Natasha, the Black Widow. Yes, it's about time she got her movie. And even though she met an untimely demise in Endgame, but getting close on the figure here. You can see pretty good head sculpt here. Find that sweet spot on the focus. There we go. Pretty good head sculpt. It seems a little weird. Not quite like Scarlett Johansson, but I think it works. I love the hair, the darker tones in the hair, that wash they put on there. Move around, you got her backpack here. Nice applications of red in there. Armor on the shoulders. That crease of the ball joint. Going across, you got the strap or whatever that is. I'm not sure what that is. It's like, is it a harness or something? Maybe it's for the sticks. That's what it is. Going down, you got her Widow Sting in gold. You do see her belt. You got a nice Widow symbol there on the gold. I'm loving the gold accents on this. This is finally like a good mix of the comic colors with that. Got the black and the gray going down to her two holsters. You got two of her accessories in there. Nice armor on the knees. You got the black boots with the heel here. Yeah, this is a solid Black Widow figure, and I dig it a lot. Good sculpting. Everything seems to be good on. I really wish they could put the butterfly joints on the females and double jointed elbows, but we'll go into that. Otherwise, I think it's a good figure. Someone that doesn't get a lot of love in the Marvel Legends universe, especially the MCU. Accessories she comes with. She does come with two closed fists. But you got the gray on there. Not too bad. Of course, I don't use the closed fists. I usually like just the open palms or holding something. Well, the holding something hands, but yeah, does have that. On her side, you can store her two handguns, and they are the same ones that came with Yelena. So there you go. It's like a nice little small semi-automatic handgun, kind of small, but perfect for, I know in the past I have gotten custom or 3D printed guns from the Black Widow figures just because I thought that she needed some handguns. The other thing she comes with are her batons. Now there's a funny thing about these. Nate had some, and he was putting them in so that they were hard to get into this little housing here. In fact, what he was doing was basically putting it down where it would go down the side. And I see why, because when I tried to do it, they just wouldn't crisscross. Problem is the backpack is just a little too close, and you can bring it out a little bit. The other problem with that is your batons are going to end up looking like this. They are very soft plastic, and of course, you see, they could have made that holster a little bit better. Even something that they knew was straight, so you could actually put the batons in there. But these are very crooked. I don't plan on displaying her with them, but as you can see, when I put these down in here, one goes in just fine. But when you try to get the other one in is when you're going to start running into problems because it just will not go. And what it'll want to do is exactly that. It just goes to the side. So what you have to do is just bring this backpack up a little bit and you can get it past the other baton. See, maybe if I can do this one first, because the problem is if you leave them like that, they'll be up and it's not very accurate. So if you get it all the way in, there you go. You just got to kind of maneuver it down and you'll get them to crisscross. So this is how they look. This is, you know, this is how you look in the movie. And yeah, but they're going to flex. They're going to bend. They're just a soft plastic. So that's just a something they could have worked on with the holsters a little bit better. Articulation wise, you've got a peg in the foot. Goes back and forth that far. Wow, it goes, that's a broken ankle. You got the twist because that peg is in the foot. No calf rotation at all. Double jointed knees. You've got a twist at the thigh. She Van Damme's about yay far, and the belt just kind of goes up. Pulls an Urkel on her. No waist articulation, but she does have a swivel joint. Ball joint, I mean, in the chest. Gets a lot of rotate, gets a lot of movement out of there. Shoulders will go all the way around, 360. Out about that far. Single jointed elbow, but it goes in about that far. No twist of the bicep or anything. The wrists will rotate and they go up and down, which is perfect for her because she's usually shooting pistols and whatnot. She does have the swivel and ball joint in the head, so she can look down about that far. The hair will kind of hinder a bit, a lot. So that's about as far as you can go back. I mean, yeah, that hair, the hair is actually pretty solid. It's not a very soft plastic. It's pliable, but that's about how far you're going to get. Comparison-wise, here she is to that first Black Widow figure that we got in the Marvel Legends series. And boy, look how far we've come. Even just getting this figure to stand was very hard in comparing with these two. And this is the last Black Widow figure that we saw. So, yeah, this one is about to fall. Like, any minute now, she's going to tip over. But these stand pretty solid, even with her kind of high heel boots. I like the boots on this Black Widow a lot better. She stands, but that's why I've kind of taken her green jacket off, replace the head on there, and that she's the one that sits on my shelf. But there might be a place for this one just because it is a very good design. And lastly, let's take a look at the Build-A-Figure Crimson Dynamo that comes with this line. And wow, for one that I wasn't that excited to get, this is actually a pretty good figure. We've gotten Crimson Dynamos in the past, but this one, wow. I know there's a lot of reuse of parts, but there's some new parts in here too. And one I like to really just show, anyway, so let's just get to the figure and look at this guy. He's massive. There's so much detail in it. Look at the head sculpt. This actually molded mouth slits and everything. Got the helmet with the visor piece there. Just looks really good. Rotating him around, you get to see some of this detail up top. Let me bring this camera back a little bit so we can get all of it. Got a little painting right there, kind of what's a turbine or an engine or something. And he's got these stacks. I just want to see smoke rising up out of them, like just a more diesel version of the armor, I guess. But you got some more back detail there. Lots of rivets, the arm joints with that metal kind of just jointed design. He's got these little translucent crystals around the arms, and one of them actually I thought it might be a defect on Nate's, but it's got a crack in it. And that's pretty cool. Just a little bit of damage. The hands, good paint applications on this guy. I love the use of the silver and the kind of rust-colored red. The you got the red star right here, and the armor, the pauldrons kind of like match right into the star, if you notice. Pretty cool. Got the closed fist over here, more of that rust and silver design. I know these legs came off the Build-A-Figure, the Mandroid, or no, the Ironmonger and the Shield Droid thing. So very good tight joints. Got more detail at the back. Got some thrusters on the bottom. Peg holes. You want to put some little blast effects in there. But yeah, this figure is pretty good. It's a pretty good Build-A-Figure. Articulation at the feet. You do have an ankle joint that goes up and down. And it will swivel. There's no peg. Actually, there's a peg in the foot because as you can see, it's swiveling at the ball on the foot. So getting that to line up properly could be an issue. But you do have double jointed knees, twist at the thighs. He Van Damme's yay far. No waist articulation, but he does have a ball jointed chest. Gets a lot of movement out of that. You've got ball jointed shoulders, and it goes about that far. It can go all the way around, but you're going to have to go around the armor, which the armor is like a separate piece as well. You have to like peg these on like that. But yeah, single jointed elbows. Wrists will go back and forth and do a 360. Same thing with the other arm. And the head is on a ball joint. But he's got a ball joint at the bottom of the neck too, so he can get some wiggle out of there. And up top. Comparison-wise, here he is next to the Kree Sentry that came out a little while ago. Not much to share between these figures, but I just thought, hey, here's a Build-A-Figure we can kind of compare it to. And I didn't even like this one, really, but just to show you, yeah, this is a good-looking Build-A-Figure and makes a good addition to your Iron Man shelf. That's what you're looking for it, and you should be. So, yeah, Crimson Dynamo, good fig. And one last shot of all the figures in the wave. I gotta say, good solid wave. I think my Master is garbage, but that's more of a personal opinion. It should be your opinion too. Spy Master is garbage. Anyway, so yeah, this line is hitting shelves at Target right now. I would go ahead and pick it up, especially for some of the MCU figures in there. The Spy Master is definite, and so is the Black Widow. But if you're looking for a good Crimson Dynamo or something with a unique design, I definitely think you should get this one. Anyway, guys, I'm Jason the X for SCNS Live. Like this video, subscribe, check out all the stuff we're doing on the channel, and I hope you're staying safe in these trying times. And hey, stay inside. Get your things sent to you, and I mean, if you go get groceries, just go to like Target or Walmart. That way you can just kind of sneak over to the toilet. Anyway, guys, stay safe out there. Much love for me. Catch you next time.